Welcome to OneCloud CX's System Administration Email Basics series. Today we will be going over the last part of a four-part series, Email Scenario Entry. While OneCloud CX does not have a dedicated scenario type for emails, we do use a scenario entry that point emails to their appropriate services. Under the Configurations tab in the Admin Home, under Scenario Entries, click the Emails tab. To create a new entry, you can press plus here, but for this example, we will be using one that has already been created. In the first tab under Account, you must define the email protocol that you'll be using and the corresponding account address and display name. We will be using POP3 and SMTP in this example. Here, we can manage our incoming email configuration. For a Gmail example to host, we will be using pop.gmail.com and we'll be using a TLS connection. Define your incoming port value and enter your email account's username and password. Here for rapid troubleshooting, you may test your connection. If the test is successful, it means we can access our incoming email with POP3. Under outgoing email configuration, we must define these values. In the case of Gmail account, we will be using the host smtp.gmail.com and the port 465. If the server you're using requires authentication, like the Gmail that we used, then you need to input your username here and your password. Then you test that and click Apply to save your changes. In the next tab under Services, you may designate the default service status in the email scenario entries associated with. This queuing priority matrix is only used if we enabled the push distribution method in the service we associate with the scenario entry. When Ignore Reply to Header is checked, OneCloud CX will disregard the info in the reply to header of an incoming email and will use the From field for identification and replies, and the Return Path header will be used for auto replies. If you leave this unchecked, OneCloud CX will use the info in the reply to header of an incoming email for identification, agent replies, and auto replies. Here you may choose to insert thread IDs in email subject lines. Note that if you disabled this option, the thread ID will be instead inserted in one of the hidden fields in the email body. Optional filters is where you add to the list of filters that will be used to sign emails arriving at the given email scenario entry to different services using keyword-based analysis. You may also choose to integrate a natural language understanding engine or a Salesforce synchronization. The last tab is the Case Fields tab, which is something we will go over in another module. Thank you for joining us on this training. For more information and trainings on our product, visit us at support.onecloud.com, and we'll see you in the next series.